ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वी आर इन ज्ञानेश्वरी चैप्टर 10 वर्स नंबर 18 verse number 18 So here we are seeing after Arjuna is saying here O Lord Swayamevatmanatmanam Vetham Tvam Purushottama Bhuta Bhavana Bhutesha Deva Deva Jagatpate O Lord of all Lords You are such a person only you know yourself nobody else can come to know you In other words only you can explain how to get to you No scriptures, nothing can tell you. In the end, the self or the Lord or the reality is self-revealing. That is what is meant here. And this is a recognition by Arjuna with regards to the Lord, that he is self-revealing. Till now he was only a friend, till now he was only a dispenser of knowledge. But after 10 chapters, he has come to realize that, oh Lord, only you can reveal yourself to others. You know yourself as yourself. Applied to subjectively is the same thing. Only the self can know the self. Mind cannot come to know the self. Mind has to vanish. And therefore, with this type of understanding, he uses the word Purushottama. Purushottama is the Uttama Purusha. As we said last time, there is Uttara and Uttama. Kshetra, Kshetrajna and the Lord. So, what is Kshetra? Kshetra is the field, Kshetrajna is the knower of the field, and the Lord is beyond both. Beyond both the manifest, another way you can put it, he is beyond both the Jiva, the Sakshi, and he is beyond both of them. Jiva and Sakshi, they are existing in the same plane of reality, which is the relative. And in this way, because the witness also is witnessing something, therefore he is not the ultimate. You have to go beyond that. And that Arjuna has recognized with regards to the Lord. It's an intellectual conviction. He hasn't had the experience yet. Then in the 16th verse he says, Vaktur Vaktum Arhasya Se. वक्तुम अर्हस्य शेषेण दिव्या ह्यात्म विभूतयः याभिर विभूतिर लोका लोकाना लोकानिम लोकाना इमाम स्तव अव्याप्य तिष्ठसि सो हियर ही सेज प्रे टेल मी इन फुल योर डिवाइन मैनिफेस्टेशन बाय व्हिच मैनिफेस्टेशंस यू रिमेन परवेडिंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड दिस इज द हाउ डू यू Without losing yourself, how do you remain in this world as everything? We lose ourselves. We become the father, mother, daughter, sister. We lose ourselves in each role. How do you do it? Not only you are taking the roles, but you are manifesting as all the names and forms. And yet, you are not losing the plot. And we always, even with one person, we lose the plot. That is his... request to the Lord, please reveal that to me. Then in the 17th verse, he says, Katham vidyamaham yogins tvam sada parichintayan keshu keshu cha bhaveshu chintyosi bhagavan maya. He says, how may I know you, O Lord, O yogi? Here the word he's used is yogi. Katha vidyam aham yogim. How do I Katham, how, aham vidyam a yogin, how do I come to know you, O yogi? He is recognizing that the Lord in front of him is the yogi of all the yogis, the Lord of the all lords. How do, tvam sada parichintayan, and how do I meditate upon you continuously while moving through this world? त्वाम सदा परिचिंतयन. सी हाउ डू आई डू दैट, बिकॉज व्हेन आई मूव थ्रू द वर्ल्ड थिंग्स ग्रैब माय अटेंशन, दे डिस्ट्रैक्ट मी. देन हाउ डू आई, इफ यू से यू आर ऑल परवेडिंग इन दिस क्रिएशन एंड आई एम अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्रिएशन एंड आई मूव इन दिस वर्ल्ड, हाउ डू आई कंटिन्यूअसली कॉन्टम्पलेट ऑन यू लॉर्ड, टेल मी प्लीज, गिव मी द इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर दैट. एंड देयरफॉर in what particular aspects are you to be meditated upon, O blessed Lord? So are there any points here, pointers? Are there any supports? Are there any techniques by which I can think about you while moving in this world? Or is it merely by your grace? Yes, it is by His grace, but then He will give Him one. And that is, towards the end of last week's lecture, I told you about what vibhuti was, isn't it? Bhuti, sambhuti, asambhuti, and vibhuti. When that point comes, I'll tell you again. And in this way, till here, we saw last week. And here, Arjuna's question is not just that he wants to meditate on the Lord while moving in the world. He says, explain your yoga very clearly so that I can meditate upon it without efforts. Sab kuch easy chahiye. And frankly speaking, it is very easy. It is the most natural thing that you can do. You don't have to put efforts. When you are not putting efforts in seeing, hearing, touching, only when there is an short-sightedness or far-sightedness, then there is a problem. But you open your eyes and seeing begins. Breathing is happening, but everything in us is naturally happening, including thinking. It is taking place by its own, of its own accord. It has its own speed. It has its own purpose to fulfill. Unnecessarily, we come in between and spoil the whole flow. The mind is only doing one thing in its entire manifestation. Go back to its own source. If we allow the mind to do what it wants and not interfere with it, very quickly you will find yourself back here. Mind will vanish. But what happens is we get identified with the mind and say, this is my mind, how can I have such thoughts, how come I am losing memory, how come I can't even remember, maybe I have to take some medicines because I am losing memory, am I getting Alzheimer's? Unnecessarily, because of the importance and value that we have given to the thoughts erupting in the mind, we start having a doubt about who we are because we get identified with that. See? And if you notice in one or two small examples, you will see even while listening, you give too much attention to one word. By the time you think about it, right now I told you that you get lost in some thought. If you give value and importance to some thought, you must have thought, where did I give importance and when you have lost myself? By that time, you have forgotten what I have, you are not available to what I have said next. See, it is that subtle. It's that much of a default process is there. So here Krishna, Arjun, Bhagwan, having reiterated to the Lord that Keshu Keshu cha bhaveshu chintyosi Bhagavan Maya, by me, in what manner, in what way, Keshu Keshu cha bhaveshu, in what manner, what different ways should I, chintyosi? How do I meditate upon you? How do I contemplate upon you? Meditation does not mean sitting and closing your eyes. That is, we have also done it. It is necessary also. But one must be very clear what is the goal of meditation. And the goal of meditation is that in and through your entire life, you are in that meditative poise. The mind is. Okay? Meditation is not for the self. Meditation is for the mind. So it must move through life in that poise where it does not get it becomes free of oscillations in spite of whatever the world is throwing at it. In spite, let it be comfort, discomfort, hunger, thirst, joys, sorrows. Something or the other will keep coming. Someone will come and pray, someone will come and insult, someone will, old friend will pick up a fight with you and go away. What can you do? You cannot do anything. It has happened. But are you getting disturbed? If you get disturbed, the oscillation, the pendulum will keep going this way, that way. What is the this way, that way? Manifestation, unmanifestation, manifestation, unmanifestation, manifestation, unmanifestation. Waking dream is manifestation, deep sleep is unmanifestation. Thinking is manifestation and non-thinking is unmanifestation. Between two thoughts, there is no thought. This way, this is the oscillation of the mind. How to get out of this oscillation? Arjuna is asking, what can I meditate upon so that I go beyond this oscillatory mind? Please guide me. So that I remain with you all the time. Because when I keep thinking, I want to think about you, and he's not doing any meditation, he's standing there and listening, probably he's sitting down and Krishna is standing. See, all photographs show, no, Krishna is standing on the ground and he's sitting up there, or standing on the chariot. Nowadays, theatres are also made like that. The teacher is standing down there. All students are looking down upon him. All the theatres, university theatres. The teacher should be looking down upon, and you should be looking up to the teacher. Ulta. Maybe they got it from Bhagavad Gita. So he is saying, ki, oh Bhagavan, how do I contemplate upon you in and through every activity of my life? In whatever the world is throwing at me, how I can remain aloof and not get swayed by it and remain focused on you? Why? Because it is important. You know yourself, and only by knowing you I will come to know that which is worthy of knowing. And that is the ultimate, because you told in the 7th chapter, Sutra Mani Ganaiva, that the whole world is strung like pearls in me. So if I come to know you, I'll come to know that secret also. In our 9th chapter, you told that the whole world is in me, and yet I am beyond the whole world. That statement, yes, I appreciate it, but how do I get there? Only through you. So please tell me. How do I contemplate upon you, O Lord? And in this, now in the 18th verse, we read that last week, it says, Vistarenatmano yogam vibhutim cha janardana bhoya kathaya truptirhi shunvato nasti me mrutam me amrutam. Come. Me amrutam. So here the Lord says in the 18th verse, no, not Lord, Arjuna is saying, he's still making his demands and from the Lord. Why? Why is he asking for all this? I have already told you, but think in different way. Why is he asking? What could be that which, what is happening inside of him? Why is he asking that? You only know yourself. Tell me how I can come to know you. How can I meditate upon you without any efforts? Why?
He's eager to experience.
The eagerness in him has reached the climax, and it's caught his imagination. Nothing in the world interests him anymore. And head over heels, he just wants to merge into the divine or have the experience of the divine. And these are all different stages. Every chapter is a different stage if you want to see it. And yet there is no stage. See? So here he says, tell me again in detail your creative power, yoga, and your manifestations, O oppressor of the foes. For while hearing your ambrosial words, I feel no satisfaction, no satiety. I do not feel fulfilled. When we are in a, someone is singing nicely bhajans or someone is doing, if we are in a satsang and we are able to hold our attention for 1.5 hours, it's only because we are interested in the topic. We are interested in the Lord, not even the topic. Topic is the Lord. That is why. That is why we are able to remain so alert. Why are we not able to do that on our own? Books are available with you. The Lord is available everywhere. But here, the support is the speaker. The support is the scripture. The support is the hearing. And all this put together is how much you will get out of all this is your yearning for the divine. All this is going on anyway, every Thursday, or so many places it's going on. But what is your disposition in any environment where satsang is going on? Are you available or not? And if you are available, what is your disposition? How much intense, relaxed thirst for the divine is there? Thirst and eagerness and yearning does not mean that you become disturbed inside. There's a deep expectancy in the mind to experience the divine, yet you know that this expectancy is not mine. It is of the mind. And as this is, so here Jnaneshwar Maharaj says that it explains the same thing in quite a few words. Ani kusaliya jiya vibhuti tyahi bolaviya bhutapati yetamanasi zari pudhati kaya sango tariha bhavamana zane jaya ho janardana pay prakrutahi amrutapana nana mahneve jevi जे काळकूटाचे सहोदर जे मृत्यु भेणे प्याले अमर तरी दिहाचे पुरंदर 14 जाती ऐसा कवण एक क्षीराब्धीचा रसु जया वायांची अमृतपाणाचा आभासु तयाचाही मीठांशु जे पुरे म्हणो नेदी तया पाबळे याही येतुलेवरी गोडियेची आथी थोरी मग हे तव अवधारी परमामृत साचे जे मंदरा चळून ढाळिता क्षीर सागरून ढहुळिता अनादि स्वभावता आयते आहे. He says that, O Lord of all beings, tell me about your manifestations, about which I have asked you, if you say why you should tell me the same thing over and over again, please do not entertain this doubt even for a moment. In other words, don't get angry when children ask the same thing. Mummy tell me. Hey, chup bitho, thode bait. Kitna puchega? So he is feeling like a kid in front of the Lord who is infinite, and he's saying, Lord has been telling the same thing from chapter 2 till now. He says, please don't get angry. In other words, why you should not get angry? Because, O oppressor of foes, for even an ordinary person is not satisfied by the drink of nectar which is offered to him every now and then. But this nectar, that the words that are coming out of the Lord's mouth, however, this nectar is, however, the brother of poison, and even though the gods drank it out of fear of death, 14 Indras rise and fall during the span of Brahma's day, this nectar, which was recovered from the churning of the milky sea, has received without any apparent reason the name of giver of immortality. but no one is sated with this sweet drink and cries enough of it. Even the gods or the Danavas, they are still fighting for that nectar. And where is it protected? It is protected in the Chandra Lok. Why it is protected in the Chandra Lok? Find out. All the seeds, before they are sown into the soil, they are exposed to the moonlight, because the nourishment, the nectar in food does not come from sun, it comes from the moon. So he says they are still fighting for that nectar. If the devas have had the nectar, then be contented, but no, now they are after protection, the others should not get it. See Rahu Ketu, they also tasted a little bit, but what good has taken place in their life? Nothing. In Dhruva Bhagwan, he had the darshan of the Lord, but what good did he do? Did it do to him? He still went and killed so many tribals. See? So here he is saying, having that nectar is nothing compared to the nectar that is flowing out of your mouth, because this is transformatory. But no one is sated with the sweet drink and cries enough of it. If such a trivial drink is held in high regard, then your talk is truly an ambrosial drink of wisdom. It has not been obtained by churning the sea of milk, by using the Mandara mountain as the churning rod. It is naturally without beginning and self-existent. Every word of the Lord in Bhagavad Gita is the doorway to reality, if you understand and interact with it in the proper manner. In Bhagavatam also the same thing is said, that even one word in Bhagavatam, if contemplated, it will take us to the Lord, because Bhagavatam itself is the Lord himself. Upanishads, they say the same thing, that everything that we are talking, that it takes you to the divine, which cannot be told by us through words in the scriptures, but those words are means. So here Krishna Bhagwan, Arjun Maharaj, he is so intoxicated by listening to the Lord's words, that he is unable to, he is giving justification to the Lord why he should repeat. So here he says in the 116th Ovi, Zed Dravananave Baddha जे थनेणी जति रसगंध जे भलताया ही सिद्ध आठवले ची फावे जयाची गोठीची एकत खेवो आघवा संसारु होय वावो बढ़िया नित्यता लागे ये वो आकणपेया जन्म मृत्युची भाख हारपोनी जाय निशेख हात बाहेरी महासुख वाढोची लागे मग दैव गत्या जरी से बिजे तरी ते आपणची होनी ठाकीजे ते तुझ देता चित्त माझे पुरे म्हणू न शके. I cannot say enough by offering my mind and intellect to the words that are being uttered by you, the ambrosial words that are coming out of your mouth. My mind and intellect is not satiated. It is not saying enough, enough. Alam, alam. Scriptures say, Upanishads say, alam. A point must come in our life where we say enough of this world. Then alone introvertedness will begin. But here it's totally different. He says, I can't say no. I can't say enough. And we must not. We must say enough to the world, but we must not say enough to satsang. We must not say enough to the words of the Lord. So here he says, it does not drip. And here he said that these words, because you are without beginning and without end, you are the knower of your own self, O Lord. Swayameva atmana atmanam. And you, from that self-knowing principle that you are, these words are coming out. So these words are also beginningless and endless. They are self-existing because they are you alone. This is a secret language. Everywhere there is contradiction. You are knower of yourself. No, I don't know myself. I know myself as body, as mind, as thoughts, as some role, husband, wife, daughter, brother, sister, waker, dreamer, deep sleeper, whatever. But sir, who are you? Who knows all this? Mandi baj gayi. See? So here, Arjun's, so he is, this is the language of love. You can never get enough of the beloved. So he's in love with what the Lord is telling him. It does not drip, is neither thin nor thick, and no one can know its sweetness or its smell, but one realizes it who yearns for it. Dekho. So what is this nectar that we are, that he is listening to? This ambrosia that is coming to his ears and filling his heart. It does not drip. Normally nectar means you pour it from somewhere. It pours out like the honey. Pictures में ऐसे दिखाते हैं ना, ऊपर से कोई कह रहा है drip कर रहा है sir, it goes into your fountain and then they say oh it's dripping from the third eye and it is dripping and you do the khechari mudra and then you catch it and you go beyond hunger and thirst and it happens. Try best weight loss program, you'll not feel hungry after that. Become ekdam pura, ekdam tight or healthy body because no hunger thirst. But you have to, and for that the yogis, they keep cutting the bottom part of your that tongue, so that, and they keep massaging the tongue so it becomes longer and longer and longer and longer. So they don't want to wait for the nectar to go from there, come to the third eye and then drip onto the tongue. No, they put the tongue backwards, push it to the third eye, and the moment it comes at the source itself, they'll catch it. And they can remain in meditation for days and days and days and days. Why? Nectar le rahe hain. Uske baad bahar, usme come out of. Why you are making that face?
To say that's gross.
Don't say they have those words in front of a yogi.
No,
eh?
No.
Meaning her. That's gross. No, but it happens. I have practiced it. I did reach there, but you can taste it. But after that, what transformation has taken place? It's only temporary. What after that? The world is still there. Anger, greed, jealousy, judgment, biasness, everything is still there. Nothing has changed after that. Nothing changes after that. Until unless you also don't come to Swayameva Atmana Atmanam. Until, just like the Lord knows himself as he is without a thought, till you don't come to that stage or state, till then everything else will remain. The world will remain separate to you. So all these are nice things. Why people pursue this then, that particular path? Because they don't want to think. That is why they practice yoga. That is why they practice pranayama. Thinking requires more energy. That is why they practice bhajan kirtan. Because this type of thinking, we are thinking right now, we are contemplating. When you are contemplating, there and then you are there. Without any lag period. Even while listening, you fall back into yourself. Ears are listening, but you fall back. That it's all happening. It is not something that you take a big milk and you heat it up and then you put a culture in it and wait for overnight and then it is set next morning. It is not like that. Realization is not like that. But some people think that it is like that. So those people who think that realization or merging into the divine or being the divine requires efforts. Yesterday someone asked, but we don't have to put efforts. I said, if you think you have to put, you have put. But you are delaying your whatever. But till that does not click, you put efforts and feel that the divine is only inspiring to you to put that efforts. Here I am also putting efforts, talking about Bhagavad Gita. But who has prompted? It's happening. Don't take ownership of anything. If it's there, good. If it's not there, also good. That is the ultimate. That if it is there, good. If it is not there, also good. But in the meantime, till all things fall in place in our head, in our heart, till the heart and head become integrated, study the Bhagavad Gita again and again and again. So here he says that because of this nectar, a birth and death subside without a trace of the supreme bliss of self-realization pervades him in and out. Which nectar? Not the one which drips, but the nectar of the Bhagavad Gita. You go beyond death. Why you go beyond death? How do you go beyond death? By recognizing that you are the deathless principle. And how do you recognize that you are deathless principle? Without a thought, not by thinking. See, my God, this is too much. But it is like that. And when this happens, then, see, as long as we are meditating on the Lord, we are seekers, and in our life, the vision has not come that everything is divine, that everything is nothing but Krishnamaya, like the gopis. Till then, we must do the sadhana. Till then, we must practice yoga, we must practice contemplation, we must. Otherwise, to feel that I am in meditation and I have achieved everything that there is wrong. Come out of meditation, meri chai kahan hai, mera khana kahan hai, mere kapde kyun nahi dhoye? Arey, phir namak zyada dal diya. This is no. If this drink becomes available to a person by good luck, it unites him with the Supreme Self. What is this nectar which comes by good luck? The nectar of the words of the Lord. And that not necessarily coming from outside. They come from within also. If you are a deep contemplator and you put a question, answer comes from within. Guidance comes from within. What to do next in your sadhana? That also comes from within. Here, Arjuna just made a complaint to the Lord without knowing that Lord is, he understands, he is Purushottam and all that, but not to the extent that he has understood now the Lord to be. He is realizing that the person who is standing in front of me is the same person that the Upanishads are talking about. But before he didn't know all this, he only thought he is an extraordinary man living on earth. And because he is so extraordinary with various powers, so all the Rishi Munis naturally pray to him or sing his glory. But he doesn't know him the way he knows now. He did not know him the way he knows now. See? It unites that person with the Supreme Self. You are giving me the such ambrosial drink of wisdom that I cannot say I have had enough of it. Oh God, I like your name. I like your name. I have also met you and enjoyed your company, and on the top of it, you are joyously chatting with me. Gita was not a instruction. It was a chat that they were having. He asked a question and out of friendly he says, I'll give you one. Klaib mein masma kama partha. And he says, "Acha, batao ye kya hai? Where am I going wrong?" Then he starts. ब्यूटीफुल. सो सत्संग कम्स इन टू अवर लाइफ ऑफ इट्स ओन बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ द लॉर्ड. इट डजंट कम बिकॉज वी हैव. महात्माज कम इन टू अवर लाइफ बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ द लॉर्ड. स्लीप कम्स इन अवर लाइफ बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ द लॉर्ड. डोंट फील दैट यू हैव अचीव्ड इट. Three things, everything is coming, but these three main things, they come by His grace. Continuing, He says, "Pathi koti sangasi." No, not this one. तुझे नामची आम्हा आवडे वरी भेदी होय आणी जवळिक जोडे पाठी गोठी सांगसी सुरवाडे आनंदाचे नी आता हे सुख कायस या सारिखे काही निर्वचे नामज परितोखे तरी ये तुले जाणे जे येणे मुखे पुनरुक्त ही हो हा का सूर्य काय शिळा अग्नि मनो येत आहे बोबिळा का नित्य वाहातया गंगा जळा पारसे पण असे तुवा स्वमुखे जे बोलिले हे आम्ही नादासी रूप देखिले आजी चंदन तरुची फुले तुरंबीत आहे मा तया पार्थाचिया बोला सर्वांगे श्रीकृष्ण डोलला मणे भक्ति ज्ञानासी जाहला आगरुहा ऐसा पति कराचिया तोषा आंतु प्रेमाचा वेगु उचं बढ़तु साया से सांभरुनी अनंतु काय बोले. He says, I do not know how to describe this happiness flowing from your talk, but it gives me great joy. I therefore feel that I should hear it from your mouth again and again. O Lord, does the sunlight ever become stale? Can one call the fire impure? Or will the ever-flowing waters of the river Ganges ever become unclean? See? When I heard your words of wisdom, I felt as if I was hearing the word of God incarnate and was smelling the flower of sandalwood, hearing this speech of Arjuna. See, this is many times you must have seen when you are doing certain bhajans or you are in a satsang or you are in a embrace of a Mahatma or in the presence of a Mahatma, you will feel this type of fragrance. An inexplicable fragrance is emanating in that area. When does that happen? When individuality has dissolved, then alone it happens. Then alone it happens. Now don't, you are sitting in your room and suddenly you start smelling that divine fragrance. Acha, my individuality has resolved. If this thought comes, means it has come back again. Watch it, accept it, don't reject it, don't retain it. Any experience that comes to you on the seat of meditation or in your life, accept all experiences, don't reject any experience, but don't retain the memory of that experience. This is important if your goal is self-realization. See, whenever a person like Arjuna, he's a dynamic fellow, he's a dhanurdhara. And when he has surrendered in wisdom to the divine, at that time four things happen in that person's life. So if you are living your life dynamically and seeing it, and while you are living your life dynamically, you are not just blindly, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. वो तो कृष्ण भगवान की लीला है, अरे वो तो उनकी राधे 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 राधे, कृपा है, कृपा है, कृपा है. बट कृपा कैसे तुम्हारे जीवन में यू नो एक्सप्रेस कर रही है. इफ यू कैन नॉट पुट वर्ड्स टू दैट कृपा, इफ यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ दैट डिवाइन ब्लेसिंग, दिस इज द होल एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ इट, देन इट इज ब्लाइंड बिलीफ. हियर इट इज बीइंग टोल्ड व्हेन अ पर्सन लाइक अर्जुना और अ डायनेमिक पर्सन इन लाइफ धनुर्धर, he surrenders in wisdom to the divine principle, or he surrenders to wisdom. See? Then four things start expressing in that person's life. First is Shri. First is wealth. Wealth not necessarily means physical wealth, gold, diamonds, not just that, but inner wealth also. All the mystic experiences, capacities, capabilities, atma bala increases. Second is aishwarya. Aishwarya means what does aishwarya mean?
Affluence.
His capacity to influence. Affluence is wealth. Aishwarya is his capacity to influence, and as a result his name and fame. That is Aishwarya. That sarva guna sampanna bolte hai na, so that is his Aishwarya. All qualities automatically find abode in him without too much trying. As the person, because he is continuously coming to the center, all the qualities automatically, only in an integrated personality, all the positive qualities start expressing themselves naturally, without even trying. Then the third is Vijaya. He is ever victorious in whatever he does, like our Mio. Ever victorious. Therefore, Arjuna is ever victorious, undefeated. And the fourth is Dhruvatiti. Dhruvatiti means he has got firm conviction without a doubt. That is perfect knowledge. So these four things, Shri, Aishwarya, Vijaya and Dhruvatiti. Wealth, inner and outer, Aishwarya, name and fame and Sarvaguna Sampanna, all qualities are expressing through him naturally.
That's word is glory.
Glory. Then third is Vijaya, he is ever victorious. And fourth is his conviction is always firm. He doesn't doubt his thoughts. He doesn't doubt his conviction. Humko kisi ko bolo, like one small child was there and we adults were talking. And some important topic was going on. This child was going play with me and creating a racket, and his grandfather was with me and he was talking to me. And you can't even hold a conversation. He wants attention from everyone. I told his grandfather, he scolded him once and twice, but he didn't stop. Then what to do? He just had that machine gun, you know, zhoing, chik, 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 and the light used to come out, and he is going around everywhere. Yaar, chup ho ja, thode de. Nahi. So we played another game. We played a game, I have got no gun in my hand. I made loud sound, louder than his gun. And when I'm making that sound, the grandfather is acting as if he is being killed. And then he will pick up the gun and he will shoot and I will die. And we were having more fun than this fellow who was going just with his gun. After 5 minutes, he threw that gun away. This daddy, this gun is bad. The Dadaji's gun is better and Swamiji's gun is better. There's no gun in our hand. Then after the moment he threw it, we kept quiet. What happened? Bullets finished. Bullets finished. Now what will happen? Oh, that truck has gone. When it comes back, then we'll start again. Till then we'll continue where we stopped before. We continued, you went away. Change of. Should I watch this serial or should I go for satsang? No, I'm going to satsang. And then while going by mistake, someone puts the TV on and yeah, that is very interesting. Satsang left, you finish the serial first. I'm going to be a brahmachari all my life. And the first girl comes across and gets married. I'm not going to eat, I'm going to get up every morning, or I'm not going to eat this food because it is not suitable to my stomach. And at the first instance, you break that resolve, isn't it? That is not firm conviction. Firm conviction means you see through whatever you have decided. So these four things, Shri, Aishwarya, Vijaya, Dhruvatiti, these come about when a person, not a lazy fellow, not a very lazy fellow, I am surrendered to God. No. You have to be dynamically living life, 24/7, living, you're out there in the world doing what is required to be done, not, no tamas in your life. Arjuna was like that. That is the ideal that is presented to us. Ready to take on any challenge that comes in front of him, if it is for the benefit of the society. Not for his own personal gain. Arjuna was not going to gain anything by this war. His brother was going to become the king. See? So in this way, as I explained last week also, that bhuti is, by the grace of God, all the wealth that comes into your life. Sambhuti is manifestation. Asambhuti is unmanifestation. So you may have overcome the bhuti. You got dispassionate towards it. Now, but the manifestation of the world is still there. You may not be attracted to anything in the world, but the world is still there. Now, how do we go from this manifest to the unmanifest? How do we get there? How do we get to that unmanifest? We are told the Lord is unthinkable. We are told the Lord is knowing himself as himself. He is self-knowing. Same also, the self is also self-knowing. How do we go from this manifest that I am, and what is my manifest understanding of myself? I am this body, breath, mind, intellect. From this four things that I know myself to be, I may have kept the world at bay. I'm not attracted to it by anything in the world. But on the seat of meditation, I still consider myself to be the thinking person. Thoughts are manifest. So from the manifest thoughts, how do I come to the unmanifest source? It is not a cup of tea for everyone. Very few people are able to do that. And for that, Arjuna Maharaj is saying, O Lord, tell me, what are the different ways? What are the different manifestations? Specific manifestations. Sambhuti is manifestation. Vibhuti is specific manifestation of the divine in the entire manifestation called the world. So we take the support of Vibhuti and it will take us to the Asambhuti. Now what is your understanding of Vibhuti? What is your understanding? Specific manifestation, I told you already. Before we go into the commentary of the Lord, what is specific manifestation? Tell me some examples. In your experience, or in your life, if it has come about, I'm not saying any esoteric experiences. That also is okay. Tell someone. Shiva.
We went to visit his ashram. Just passed away now.
Sai Baba.
Yes, Sai Baba's.
So he was a part of the creation, and yet there was a specific creation called Vibhuti.
Yeah.
So that it is called Vibhuti, because it is even now I have that Vibhuti. It is ever fragrant. Okay. What else? But that is someone else created something else. What is your experience?
Well, I got some of this.
What is your? Like we went, I don't know, you didn't come. We went to Mysore, and on halfway to Mysore, there is that Vishnu temple. Srirangam or? Not Srirangam. Srirangam. So just when you enter that road, there, in the corner, there is Sai Baba orphanage. And we went into the orphanage, and there is one bowl, silver bowl or steel bowl, I can't remember now. Continuously for last 20 years, a divine nectar keeps coming out of it, and they keep collecting it, jars are full. Amazing taste. Imagine the vibhuti that you, that fragrance that you get, imagine tasting it, how it would be. Can't put any taste to it, just out of the ordinary. And we all tasted it, and then he gave me that small katora, bowl, kept it in my hand. In my hands, within 5 minutes, it was already quarter full. From where is it coming? This is all mystical. I'm not talking from mystical point of view. Is this body a specific manifestation? Is this body specific? Is it a unique one among all the 7 billion people? It is. Is the breath which has come out just now, there is a breath as a principle is there, air as a principle is there, but this breath which has just come out or just gone, it, is it ever going to repeat again? It's specific. Isn't it? Is the thought that you have just now, is it ever going to repeat? Oh, I can say oh hundreds of times, but every time it will be unique. So is it specific? Is it unique? So not just understand specific among mountains I am Himalayas, that is specific. Among rivers, I am Ganga, that is specific. We'll see how the Lord starts telling from where He wants you to begin. If you don't understand, then He keeps going. We'll see from where He begins. So here, Arjuna is asking, where are we? He says, I felt, when I heard your words of wisdom, I felt as if I was hearing the words of God incarnate and was smelling the flower of sandalwood, the fragrance of sandalwood. This comes, as we said, as a result of a surrender of no ego. And when Lord heard such a yearning in the heart of Arjuna, now see what Lord says. This should be the relationship between teacher and student, or student and teacher. This should be the relationship between parents and children. See? The Lord says, hearing the speech of Arjuna, Lord Krishna started reeling with great joy. He went into ecstasy. When the teacher sees that his disciple is, his understanding has come to a certain, he is in joy. And he says, this Partha has verily become the repository of both knowledge and devotion. What you have just now said in the last few verses, requesting me to tell you what is the vibhuti, how I can recognize you. Everything that you have said is not just a devotional language. It is devotion with wisdom. That is because he is telling what he has understood about the Lord, and at the same time he is showing the inquenchable thirst for knowing more. See, that knowing more will only come where there is faith and there is devotion, there is love, and yet there is a trickle of what you call wisdom. So all the words of Arjuna, it's the essence of all that he has learned in life, and everything what Krishna has told him till now, and his own contemplation, that is the juice of it. And because he has understood so much, his arrogance has not increased. He is saying, oh Lord, all this is I recognize by your grace, and I am thirsty to know more. So please tell me, how can I remain functioning in this world as I am functioning dynamically, yet never be divorced from the divine? Krishna is his charioteer only for 18 days. After that he will go away. How will I continue to be with you even after that? So, delighted by Arjuna's speech, the Lord experienced the exhilaration of love for him. Just like the Lord becomes very, very thrilled by the tapasya, devotion of his devotee. Similarly, the teacher also becomes very, very thrilled when he sees the disciple is come to a certain understanding, has grown in his stature, is helping many more people. Guru Maharaj also feels very happy. He is not feeling jealous. How come you are getting there? How come you are more famous than me? Tapon Maharaj and Chinmayananda. Tapon Maharaj was in Himalayas, in Uttarkashi, never came down from there. 40, 50 years he was there. And he will have only one or two disciples at a time. And they will all leave him eventually, not eventually, over the years. Why? Because he was so strict. He will repeat only once, and that too in Sanskrit. And if he asks you the meaning of it, you must be able to tell it. If you don't, get out of the class. No more coming. Chinmayananji went, studied with him. He said, Swamiji, I feel I'm inspired by Ganges. She starts from the Himalayas, but she goes and flows down into the plains and nourishes everyone. He says, but people pollute it. Tapon Maharaji says, but people pollute it. And eventually, yes, it eventually goes and merges into the ocean, all that is fine. You don't go. You remain here. Let people come to you. Tapon Maharaj never went down. He gave that instruction to Chinmayananda. Chinmayananda said, no, I want to go. And it is an uncontrollable force that is pushing me to go. He says, okay, I'll give you... If you are successful for 1 month, go get pushed, thrown, insulted everywhere in the world, and then you come back. And then if you have survived 1 month, then you can go. See? So when he went, he became so famous, Chinmayananji, so many ashrams, so many devotees, and Tapon Maharaj, nobody, only a handful. Acha. He studied from me and he's using my knowledge to get name and fame. This is how people talk, no? But there is no jealousy. Good, go. Whatever life has to teach you, it will teach you eventually. No master worth his salt will ever be jealous of the success of his disciple. So also, the Lord, he is thrilled. He is thrilled. Because the interaction of Arjuna with him is that of what you call unrestrained love. And it is showing in his demeanor, it is showing it in his speech, it is showing it in his eyes, it is showing it in his disposition. And looking at all this in Arjuna, the Lord also becomes thrilled. And what does he say? He says, and delighted by Arjuna's speech, the Lord experienced the exhilaration of love for him, but collecting himself with great difficulty, he began to speak. The Lord also got overwhelmed with love that was coming from Arjuna, that someone can really love so much, and became emotional. Even though Lord doesn't, he is aloof from everything, yet he felt the emotion. This is the language of devotion only. He is devoted to the Lord. Here somewhere it will come. How Lord addresses Arjuna. He doesn't call him Arjuna. He says Ba. He calls him Father. If someone comes, same question. Swamiji, what is prarabdha? Swamiji, karma yoga zaruri hai kya? Swamiji, this. Tum pagal ho jaoge baad mein. Yaar, tu kahin kisi dusri dukaan pe ja. Nisargadatta Maharaj used to say, go to the other shop. It is not available in this shop. Prarabdha, rebirth. Then, if someone says, comes with their own contemplation. There are some people you meet, every time they call you for bhiksha, the same question they will ask every time. So last 10 years I have gone to their house, same question, man. Aage bhi padho. Hum bhi time pass karke nikal jate hain wahan se. Waise bhi time pass hi kar rahe hain. Par kahin pe dikhta hai, somewhere you see that someone is sincerely, they have contemplated and their own conclusions. And you can see that in a person's I and how they are asking. But such also people are fooled. They ask you such a serious question and you, like a fool, start answering it very seriously, and the first phone call comes, they leave you talking and they are answering the phone call. Then you learn the lesson. Next time, unko ghuma do par khud mat ghumo. They are not sincere. What do you call, in Bangalore, went to Hubli, drove back, and in the evening there was satsang in someone's house. And they have known me, they were in Sydney, now they are in there, in Bangalore, and where I stay, just opposite house, they have bought the house. So their sister, she happened to be there, and she saw me after 3 years. Oh, Swamiji, you are having coffee here, but you will have to have come for bhiksha at our place. I said, why? We will meet here only. When I come, then I have to change and we have to go the next day. No, you have to come and grace the house, this, that, blah, blah, sab kuch ho gaya. Aur wahan gaye, to ye jo Shyam hai, he, while going to their house, he started some questions. And the satsang began. Went there. I know he understands whatever we are talking about. But udhar jab shuru ho gaye, from where we stopped in the car, we continued there. And he's pricking me here and there. Hey, why? But why this? I said, don't you understand? No, but. Bevku bana rahe, main kya bandar hu? Chabi de di aur main apna gugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugugug करना शुरू हो जाओ एंड यू फॉर्मुलेट क्वेश्चंस अकॉर्डिंग टू द टॉक दैट इज गोइंग टू कम आउट. नहीं नहीं स्वामी जी, इन द एंड व्हाट डज ही से? ही सेज नो स्वामी जी, द रीजन आई बिहेव दैट वे इज आई वॉन्ट यू टू स्पीक मोर एंड मोर एंड मोर एंड मोर दैट आई डोंट गेट सेटिस्फाइड. लास्ट टाइम आई वॉज देयर लास्ट ईयर टिल नाइट 1 o'clock वी वर टॉकिंग इन फ्रॉम टू सत्संग चल रहा था, खाना खा लिया फिर भी चल रहा है. मैंने कहा यार बस हो जाए, तेरे को कल काम पे जाना है, आई एम फ्री, आई गॉट नो प्रॉब्लम. यू हैव टू, नहीं नहीं स्वामी जी यू डोंट कम एवरी ईयर दिस दैट. तो भाव ऐसा होता है यू डोंट फील टायर्ड ऑल्सो, इजंट इट? व्हेन वी वर इन द आश्रम महात्मा सम ऑफ द पीपल, आई वॉज नॉट एक्सपोज टू दैट मेनी महात्मास. नाउ आई हैव मेट मेनी, But that time, some of the brahmacharis who were there in the course studying Vedanta, they had met many Mahatmas in India, they had met Swami Chinmayananda, they had met other Mahatmas, and after the whole day, grueling day, 5, 6 classes a day, after that washing all the dishes for breakfast, lunch and dinner of 150 inmates in the ashram, still few of us, we used to get together and the question answer used to be, which Mahatma you have known, or tell me something more about your experience of Swamiji's that you have come to know. And 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock will go on, will not feel tired. There have been times when we whole night we are going, and now it's time for meditation at 5 o'clock in the morning. So now though, or go straight to the temple for meditation. You don't get tired in these topics, but that disposition is important. So the Lord says here, showing this, he says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Antate Kathayishyami, Divyahyatma Vibhutayaha, Pradhanyata Kuru Shrestha, Nastyanto Vistarasyame. He says, the Lord says, well then I shall recount to you my divine manifestations, but only the chief ones, only the important ones. O best of Kurus, for there is no limit to my expanse. I can continue to speak about my vibhutis, my specific manifestations, eternally. If truth is eternal, so also is the phenomena. Phenomena is also eternal. And what is the eternity of phenomena? Manifestation or non-manifestation? Manifestation, non-manifestation. And every time this manifestation and non-manifestation happens, it's a new manifestation. So he says, I'll keep talking about it. But the Lord knows. He says, but I'll tell you, they are eternal, but I'll tell you only the important ones, the specific ones, by knowing which your mind gets directed towards the principle behind these vibhutis, that it becomes contemplative, so that by listening, vibhutis are just a step on the ladder, it is not the ultimate. What did we tell you? Sambhuti, manifestation, to asambhuti, unmanifest. What is unmanifest? The Paramatma, the Lord, the Ishwara. And what is manifestation? The world. And in that world, the Lord is appearing in a particular form. Yes. So how do we, is that form the Lord? And yet the Lord is saying, the whole world is in me. That means the entire manifestation is in me. And yet I am beyond the manifestation. Remember in the 9th chapter he told. But how do I work this out in my head? How do I come to that unmanifest source? The divine source, which cannot be known through the thoughts, which is self-knowing principle. How do I come to know that? So the Lord here is saying, through the specific manifestations. So here is Lord is saying, so Jnaneshwar Maharaj is saying, Ya chitrace nirupana eka mi pita mahacha pita he athavita hi nathave chitta ki manata seva pandusuta bhale kele. Arjunate va mane ethakahi amha vismo karavaya karana nahi आंगे तोले करू काही नवेची नंदाचे परी प्रस्तुत ऐसे असो हे करवी आवडीचा अतिसो मग मणे आई के सांगत असो धनुर्धरा तरी तुवा पुसलिया विभूती तयाचे अपारपण सुभद्रापती ज्या माझी याची परी माझी ये मती आकळती ना आंगीची आरोमा किती जयाची या तयासी न गणवती तैसिया माझिया विभूती असंख्य मज. He says, forgetting that he was the father of Brahma, the creator, Lord Krishna said to Arjuna, the Lord Krishna, as the Paramatma, he is the father of Brahma. Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, who are they? They are specific manifestations of, from the Rajasic Shakti. The Maya, the manifestation, first expresses as Sattva Rajas Tamas. The total Rajas, when consciousness or Paramatma expresses through that total Rajas, he is called Brahmaji. When he expresses through the total Tamas, he is called Shiva. And when he expresses, the Paramatma expresses through the total Sattva, he is called Vishnu. Individually, from the individual Rajas, he is called the dreamer. The technical word for it is Tejas. When he expresses through the individual Sattva, micro Sattva, not macro, he is called the Waker, the Vishwa. And from the when he expresses through the individual tamas, he is called the deep sleeper. So this is the phenomena. See? So the Lord, he is always aware of who he is. So here, just out of that language, he forgets that he is the father of Brahma. He started, the Lord Krishna said to Arjuna, Ba Arjuna, here he says, where are we? मी पितामहाचा पिता. पितामह नॉट द भीष्माचार्य. पितामह इज द फादर ऑफ ऑल फादर, दैट इज ब्रह्माजी. मैं उसका भी बाप हूँ. आई एम हिज फादर, द क्रिएटर्स फादर आई एम. फॉरगेटिंग दैट आई एम दैट क्रिएटर्स फादर, ही कंटिन्यूज टू स्पीक, बा अर्जुना यू हैव स्पोकन वेल, बट यू शुड नॉट फील एनी सरप्राइज दैट द लॉर्ड कॉल्ड अर्जुना बा, बिकॉज had he not become himself the son of Nanda. What is so strange about it? When the Lord himself is manifesting as Nanda also, and yet coming there as a child, knowing everything, he has not forgotten himself. Ramchandra ji did not know he is Lord Vishnu. Only after Yoga Vashishta, he comes to realize himself. He invoked the Maya on himself. But Krishna Bhagavan, from the moment before birth, during birth, after birth, till he stopped, concluded his manifestation, he was fully aware of who he is. Fully aware. So he himself, he was calling Nanda Baba Baba, Yashoda Maya Maya, did all them drama there. So such, if he calls Arjuna as father, no surprise, don't be surprised. When there is excess love, such things happen. When we are in the retreat, this small girl was there. And I was continuously calling her mummy, mummy, my young mummy, my child, small mummy. And she took it seriously. And she came to feed me at the dining table. She had, and then I was lying on the road, and she came and she took my head and put it on her lap. Oh, mummy will take care. Mummy will give you massage. Mummy, choti 6 saal ki. You understand the bhav there? Same bhav Krishna is having towards Arjuna by calling him father. It's excessive love. Then the Lord said, Oh, archer, Dhanurdhara, listen to what I am going to say. My manifestations about which you ask me are unlimited in number. They are endless, eternally going on. So even though they are my manifestations, they are beyond the comprehension of my intellect. Just as no one can count the number of hair on one's body, I cannot count my manifestations. Oh, Lord is saying that it is beyond my intellect. Is that a blasphemy on the Lord? Lord is saying it is beyond my intellect. How can anything be beyond Lord's intellect? Good, spot on, because the Lord in his essential nature does not have a mind. What is the difference between Lord and individual? Individual has mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar. This is the inner equipment. Lord does not have mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar. Spot on. So how can he know? And even if he was to know, can you remember everything in your past and can you remember everything in your future? Even if you had that ability, you can't even remember sequentially how your day went from morning till now. Today, not forget yesterday, today also. You can't tell me sequentially what manifested one after the other. Isn't it? The Lord says that phenomena happens. I don't create the phenomena, it happens. And it is eternal. So Lord has also come to conclusion he cannot understand his Maya, meaning understand his Prakriti. But he can control the Prakriti. We cannot control the entire light, but we can control the light. Isn't it? We cannot control the fire, but if we follow the rules of fire, we can control the fire, make it submissive. Same thing is the Lord. Lord himself is expressing as Prakriti. But when it comes to explaining its expanse, he finds himself incapable. So he says, so even though they are my manifestations, they are beyond the comprehension of my intellect. Just as no one can count the number of hair on one's body, I cannot count my manifestations. And therefore, he says, Hervitari mi kaisa kevadha manauni apanapaya hi naveci phuda ya lagi pradhana jiya rudha tiya aike ziya zanat liya saati aghavi ya zanavati lakiriti jaise bij aliya mudhi रुचि आला होए का उद्यान हाता चढ़िनले तड़ीप आ पैसी सांप पड़ली फले फुले देवी देख लिया जिया देख भले विश्व सकल एवी साचची का गा धनुर्धरा नाही शेवटु माझिया विस्तारा पै गगना आयशिया अपारा मजमाजी लपणे. He says, even though otherwise I am myself not aware of what I am and how great. I am not aware of what I am and how great I am. Because what I am, how great the Lord is, only others talk about him, no? You say from here, Om Bhurvasva Tatsa Vidurvarinam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi. We say to the prayer to the Lord. These people do 108 Surya Namaskar to the Lord. The Lord must be, the sun must be tickled. He says, they are saying, Om Bhurvasva, you are illuminating. What is illumination? I don't understand. From Lord's point of view, sun's point of view, there is no understanding of what light is. Oh, Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, thank you for removing the darkness and giving us light. He doesn't understand what darkness is also. Oh, you are the repository of all knowledge. Because you are of the nature of light. He says, I don't know what it is. He cannot know. Because that which is his nature, how can you know what your nature is? You are already that. Similarly, the Lord says here that I am myself not aware of what I am and how great I am. Therefore, I shall tell you my foremost manifestations. If you comprehend them, you will come to know what the other, you will come to know the other manifestations too. Just as one becomes possessed of the tree if he has the, he has its seed, or if one owns the garden, one becomes possessed of its flowers and fruits. So by knowing my manifestations, you'll grasp the whole universe. O Partha, there is no end to my expanse, since even things as big as the vault of heaven are contained within me. So, just as a seed, if it is there in your hand, the potential of the tree, the trunk and the shoot and the fruits and the flowers of the tree, they are yours. Just like if you are an owner of a garden, all the fruits and flowers are yours. You don't have to take anyone's permission to pluck whichever flower you want. And the third example he took was, third is that if you come to know some of my manifestations, which I'm going to tell you, he's going to tell him 73 manifestations. He said, which will cover an entire span, give him a general vision of the total universe, and then by interacting with those vibhutis in correct manner, an environment will be created that the knowledge will, you can go and pluck whatever knowledge you want. Otherwise, people like Narad Muni, they had the knowledge of 64 vidyas, knowledges. Yet they were feeling empty inside, that I am not feeling complete, I am not feeling fulfilled. Before Narad Bhakti Sutra began, this was the, the beginning of it. And then his elder brother Sanat Kumaras come and they say, you may be best at Jyotish, you may be best at warfare, you may be best at administration, you may be best at all the siddhis, everything you are good at, but you haven't experienced love yet. It's all intellectual, your heart has not opened up yet. And then he says, what is there worthy of loving? He says, the Lord, our maker. Which Lord? Who is the father of our father? Who is their father? Brahmaji. Who is the father of the father? Narayana or Paramatma, whatever you may call it. He says, fall in love. And they initiate him into the mantra. And he begins and becomes one of the greatest devotees. And such a great devotee of the Lord, Narayana, says, if there is the greatest example of devotee and devotion and surrender in the world, they are the gopis. So imagine how great the gopis must be. These are things to just ruminate when you are in your silence with a cup of tea or on the seat of it. It will transport your mind. You go beyond your mind. By thinking, you will not go beyond your mind. By contemplating on such themes, there is a possibility. And that possibility is being made present to Arjuna through the vibhutis. What it is, what are those vibhutis, etc. We'll see in our next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.